मेरे साथ लोकसभा में कांग्रेस संसदीय दल के नेता अधीर रंजन चौधरी जी और हमारे चीफ व्हिप के सुरेश भी मौजूद हैं। राष्ट्रपति का जो आज का अभिभाषण है वो केवल सरकार की घोषणाएं और प्रधानमंत्री के शब्दों को दोहराता है। उसे देश आश्वस्त नहीं हो सकता कि आने वाले समय में जो वातावरण भारत के अंदर है ये सरकार सही माने में गंभीर है उसमें सुधार लाने के लिए। हर भारतवासी ये चाहता है कि जो सरकार ने कहा है, आश्वासन दिए हैं, वो पूरे हों। पिछले 5 साल का अनुभव बड़ा कड़वा है। 5 साल पुराना राष्ट्रपति का अभिभाषण 2014 का निकाल कर देखें, उसमें से कितना पूरा किया गया उसी से स्पष्ट हो जाएगा कि आज के अभिभाषण को ज़्यादा महत्व देना शायद हम उचित नहीं समझते। वस्तु स्थिति ये है कि राष्ट्रपति के अभिभाषण में कोई जिक्र नहीं किया गया बेरोजगारी का, जो 45 साल का सबसे ऊंचा आंकड़ा है हिंदुस्तान में बेरोजगारी का, 7 दशमलव के लगभग पहुंच रहा है, करोड़ों नौजवान बेकार है और 2014 का 2 करोड़ रोजगार एक साल का वो पूरा नहीं हुआ। उसी तरह से अगर इन्होंने कहा आज के अभिभाषण में, शुभकामनाएं हमारी सरकार को कि किसानों की आमदनी वो दुगना करेंगे 2022 तक, कृषि का जो औसतन दर है हमारा बढ़ोतरी का, ग्रोथ का, वो 2.5 और 2.9 के बीच में है। उस हिसाब से लगभग 45 साल लगेंगे किसानों की आय को दुगना होने में। तीसरा, निवेश की बात कही है पर देश में निवेश टूटा है, आर्थिक मंदी का कोई जिक्र इसमें नहीं है। एक विवादास्पद मैं कहूँगा उस बात को, राष्ट्रपति के अभिभाषण में अभी शायद शामिल करना न्यायोचित नहीं था कि एक देश में एक चुनाव होगा, एक साथ सब जगह चुनाव होगा। अभी तो कल अगर राजनीतिक दलों की बैठक भी बुलाई गई उसमें कोई आम सहमति नहीं है, उसमें काफ़ी राजनीतिक दल, बड़े राजनीतिक दल उसमें शामिल नहीं हुए। भारत के संविधान को देखते हुए, विविधता को देखते हुए और इस बात को स्वीकार करते हुए कि हम एक संघीय प्रणाली हैं, किसी भी राज्य के अंदर किसी भी सरकार की ये प्रस्तावना कि एक सरकार 5 वर्ष तक रहे, सब चाहते हैं, मतदाता भी चाहते हैं, पर अनुभव ये है आज़ादी के बाद का, पहले तो एक साथ चुनाव हुए थे पर सरकारें गिर गई थी, उनका बहुमत खत्म हो गया था, वैकल्पिक सरकारें बन नहीं पा रही थी, इसलिए मध्यावधि चुनाव होते हैं। तो ये जो बात मैं कहूँगा व्यावहारिक दृष्टिकोण से भी जो बात संभव ना हो उसको अभिभाषण में सरकार की तरफ से एक सोच लाना अगर बेहतर होता उसको शामिल नहीं किया जाता। और अगर सबका साथ सबका विश्वास कि प्रधानमंत्री की और इस सरकार की गंभीरता है, घोषणा नहीं, शब्द नहीं है, क्योंकि शब्द हमने 5 साल में बहुत सुने हैं, वो शब्द कहाँ तक लेके गए हैं भारत को वो देश जानता है, जहाँ तक हमारे रोज़गार, कृषि क्षेत्र, किसान और भारत की जीडीपी और अर्थव्यवस्था की बात है। पर अगर ये प्रधानमंत्री सही रूप में ये करना चाहते हैं, एक नया चैप्टर मैं कहूँगा शुरू करना चाहते हैं, खोलना चाहते हैं, तो बीजेपी को जो खुले आम दल बदल को प्रोत्साहन देके 3 राज्यों में कांग्रेस की सरकारों पर निशाना लगा रही है उसको बंद करना चाहिए। एक तरफ तो निरंतर सरकारी तंत्र का, शासन का बीजेपी के पास पूरे साधन हैं, उसका दुरुपयोग हो रहा है कांग्रेस की सरकारों को अस्थिर करने के लिए, डिस्टेबलाइज करने के लिए। तो इसलिए ये शब्द इनका, मैं कहूँगा, ज़मीनी हकीकत से सीधा टकराते हैं। वो हमको विश्वास करना उसमें तभी संभव हो पाएगा जब जो हो रहा है वो बंद होगा। As I have said that the president's address is uninspiring, it's insipid, it's hollow, it's full of platitudes. It just repeats the statements of the prime minister or the executive decisions taken by the union cabinet after the assumption of office following the general elections. There is no reference whatsoever of the past commitments made to the people of India in the presidential addresses by the government beginning with 2014. There is no mention of the jobs, unemployment, which has touched the highest number of 45 years. There are two numbers. One is the official data, which confirms it's 6.1%. So crores of our youth are unemployed. It would have been better if the president in his address had expressed concern and given a roadmap of job creation, job generation month-wise. That would have reassured the people and especially the younger generation. Also with regard to the economy, there is an economic slowdown in the country. Our GDP number in the last quarter has fallen to 5.8%. The global rating agencies have downgraded India's GDP growth even after the assumption of office by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi for the second time as the Prime Minister. There is a near unanimous view that our growth will be about 6.6%, well below 7%. The president's address talks about taking India's GDP to $5 trillion. We wish the government good luck, but for that they have to revive economic growth, investment, manufacturing, which is at a 10-year low. They have to restore the health of the Indian banks to lend to the micro, small and medium enterprises. The fact is that the banks have huge or staggering loans, also NPAs, and the merger of banks is still an ongoing process. Presently, where we are with the GDP and the growth rate which I have just given, it will not be possible. We all want India's GDP to grow fast, so it's not just criticism for the sake of it. But in the first 5 years of this government, India's GDP had grown by barely $0.7 trillion, or $600 billion to be precise. Whereas in the previous 10 years of UPA, India's GDP had quadrupled from $480 billion to over $2 trillion. For us now to reach $5 trillion in 5 years from today, it's very clear that we need to grow in double digit, not less than 11-12% for continuously for 5 years. Similarly, with regard to the farmers' income, mere platitude or a statement in a president's address or the government's or the BJP's assurance does not address the real crisis in India's agriculture. We have to look at what investments have been there in agriculture. In the last 5 years, please pick up the numbers. In percentage of the GDP, the investment in agriculture has continuously fallen. Agriculture growth is barely 2.5 to 2.9%. For the farmers' income to double, at this growth rate, it will take 45 years. That's why I've said that it is full of platitudes and just a repeat of the statements made by the Honorable Prime Minister or the executive decisions of the cabinet. It does not give any account of the unfulfilled promises of the last 5 years, which you are aware of. I won't go into more details, but to our youth, to our farmers, what has happened? If Prime Minister wants to open a new chapter, seeking the cooperation to build consensus on important matters, then that sincerity of intent must be reflected in the actions of the BJP and its government, which it is not being reflected, because from day one they are out to encourage defection, destabilization and targeting of the Congress governments, which we say must stop immediately. Equally, we have expressed our concern that, or the justification of including this issue of one nation simultaneous polls. We have a constitution. India is a union of states. We are a federal polity. We cannot have uniformity imposed, which is impractical, because the governments are elected by the people, both the national government and the state governments. And the state governments have remained in office, as our experience says, as long as they command majority. There are many states where the governments have lost majority and alternate governments formation has not been possible. But people cannot be deprived of a popular government. That's why the midterm polls have taken place. You cannot impose an idea which is actually takes away this diversity or the rights of the states or the rights of the people. So this is premature, I would say. We have not participated as a party in yesterday's meeting. But it is something which I'll say not even premature. It's an idea which has yet to be put in an incubator. So we have our reservations and our concerns. But the larger issue which we have said, that this president's address, we will speak in both the houses. Our leader in Lok Sabha is here, he will tell you. When the debate starts on the president's address,
Monday,
then we will be speaking in detail in the Lok Sabha and in the Rajya Sabha to put on record our views and our concerns. But for the time being, as I have summed it up, it's just platitudes, the repeat of words, high-sounding words, which the Prime Minister and the BJP government are very fond of. They are very fond of that. When it comes to those words, we have seen those words in the last 5 years: Stand Up India, Start Up India, Skill India, Make in India, and where the manufacturing has declined, where the investments have declined to historic lows. Yes, we want manufacturing to grow. We want India to become a manufacturing hub. But for that, a lot of work has to be done. And we will see what is done for the skilling, what's done for job creation, and what kind of policies the government makes, which actually reverses the economic slowdown, which is of a national concern. Okay. देखिए, ये तो मैं कहूँगा कि इस तरह की टिप्पणी करना और उस पर हमारी कोई प्रतिक्रिया भी हो, वो सुन रहे थे, हम साथ ही बैठे थे, कब कितना सुना जाए, जितना जरूरी है उतना सुन लेते, वो सुन लिया, प्रतिक्रिया पार्टी की तरफ से हम दे रहे हैं। अगर बीजेपी वाले ऐसी बात करते हैं, अब बीजेपी का कौन सा नेता उस समय कहाँ देख रहा था, कौन किससे बात कर रहा था, ये तो ऐसी एक गंभीर राजनीतिक दल को और वो सत्ताधारी दल को ऐसी टिप्पणी नहीं करनी चाहिए।
Constantly disrespecting the office of the president by talking. You were
No, no, there were certain queries about certain words. There were some difficult Hindi words which or they did not hear them clearly as to what was said. So that's nothing. There's nothing disrespect as it is being said. No, I think it's very frivolous if the BJP is saying it. If the footage is taken, then half of the ministers were talking to each other, senior ministers, then were they disrespecting the president? It's not fair comment.
Yeah, you have rightly pointed out, we are also discussing on this issue that both the states which are situated on the two fringes of our country, Kerala and Bengal, BJP party has been focusing on these two states. It was even manifested when our Prime Minister was waiting himself against Prasad in Kerala while on his way to Sri Lanka. So since then, BJP party has been exhausting all its resources to capture Kerala on the one hand and Bengal also. Already they have made a good progress in Bengal also, we cannot deny it. But certainly your point is very much relevant in today's presidential address, when the government's intention was clearly demonstrated by the address made no fewer than President himself.
Does it call for greater opposition unity in Bengal, Congress is Trinamool?
See, no, this is different kettle of fish. What we are talking about, that the objective of the party is very much distinct, because already they have set their target in the coming election. Now they are holding 303 rifle. They are hoping for INSAS rifle later on. So we have to wait to see various kind of, game plan made by BJP party. And it is a solemn occasion, presidential address is a solemn occasion. So I must suggest the government that the height, the dignity of this kind of solemn occasion should not be degraded. That is I'm not talking about. It is implicit. That what they are going to do. Why I am talking about that the solemn position should not be degraded? Already my senior has pointed out that it was a highfalutin address without having any adequate substance.
Correct.
So people, I think it's simply a deviationary tactics being played by the BJP party when in all fronts they are failing. They are failing in all fronts miserably. Now they are trying to deflect the attention by raising an issue, one nation, simultaneous election, without any rhyme or reason. Whether country now, it is imperative need for the country right now, whether this is the only issue in the country right now, but they are simply creating an issue out of the blue, only to have a situation which may deflect the attention of the people from the core issue of their livelihood. Is it not, Anji?
Yes.
अरे पीएम किसी का नहीं होता, पीएम एक चेयर होते हैं,
देश का होता है,
पीएम देश का होते हैं। हम जानते हैं कि एटीकेसी किसको कहते हैं, जरूर जाना चाहते हैं, जरूर जाऊंगा, लेकिन पीएम मतलब ये नरेंद्र मोदी जी का नहीं है, ये हिंदुस्तान की प्राइम मिनिस्टर ने बुलाए हैं। हम लोग एटीकेसी जानते हैं, वो एटीकेसी के मुताबिक, शिष्टाचार के मुताबिक कहाँ क्या करना चाहिए, आप देखते रहो।
लेट्स बी वेरी क्लियर, आवर गुड विशेज गो टू द न्यू गवर्नमेंट। द गवर्नमेंट हैज टू डू इट्स जॉब, द ऑपोजिशन हैज टू डू इट्स जॉब, बट वी अंडरस्टैंड अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज एंड ड्यूटीज। एज अधीर रंजन जी हैज सेड, इट्स नॉट अ बिग थिंग that the Prime Minister has invited the members of Parliament. He's an institution. He's the Prime Minister of the country. Once you take the oath as the Prime Minister, you're not the Prime Minister of the BJP. You're Prime Minister of India. And we are members of Parliament of India. All of us. Parliament is an institution. So is the Prime Minister. That's how it should be viewed.
And we are optimistic that there would have a sumptuous dinner also.